So I've managed to get out on site, and this video will link nicely to videos that I've made recently on the insulation resistance test. In BS7671's on-site guide, it shows you doing the insulation resistance test with all the circuits at the same time, which is almost impossible where RCDs are inside of the consumer unit. But in this consumer unit, we don't have any, so we can do all the insulation resistance tests from the outgoing side isolated there, the supply has been isolated, the outgoing side of that main switch. We can do all the line and neutrals together, all the line and CPCs, and all the neutral and CPCs as a one test. And to help me do that test, I've been joined by Marcus today. Hello, and mate. You're going to set up your instrument first for me, yes?
Yeah, so I've got the Megger 1711 here. We're going to set it to the insulation resistance setting, and we're going to do it on 250 volts DC first. I know it's normally 500 volts, but we believe we've took out every appliance, took out every lamp in all of the circuits. But just to be sure, we're going to test it at 250 just to make sure we don't damage anything if there is something still in circuit.
So you're trusting the fact that I've turned the boiler off?
Yes.
Okay.
So first of all, I'm just going to test my leads together.
So you linked your leads together. So yep. If I look back here, if your leads are together and you've got a dead short, which is accepted.
Yeah, because that way I know my leads are not damaged.
So if they were broken, you'd have an infinite reading, wouldn't you?
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
So this is all the circuits. Can you remind me of the smallest amount of insulation resistance that we can get before further investigations required?
So before further investigation is required, it can't be lower than 2 megohms.
And that's the whole installation?
It is, yes.
Okay, and when we say the minimum accepted is?
Is 1 megohm.
Okay, so you're gonna first of all connect all the neutrals together, and which conductor are you gonna do it first to?
So I'm gonna go between line and neutral at first.
Okay, so that's onto the line connection, which is on the outgoing side of the main switch, which is isolated.
Yeah, I'm just gonna do it at 250 volts DC first. And again, it's creeping up now. It's gone way over the accepted value. So okay. It's looking around 56, 57 megohms.
Okay.
That is on 250 though. So now I'm comfortable. There's nothing in circuit that I can damage. I'm going to test it at 500 volts.
Okay, brilliant.
DC. And again, that has gone to an acceptable value. Looking around 57 megohms. I do have to change this consumer unit over. So I like to do these pre-tests beforehand to make sure when we're adding new devices in, especially when we go between CPCs and lines, CPCs and neutrals, the RCBOs we're going to install are not going to trip.
What conductors are going to test between next, Marcus?
So now we're going to go on to the earth bar in the consumer unit and test between the earth bar and the line conductor. We're going to keep it on 500 volts because we're not worried about anything being in circuit now between, we've already tested between the live conductors.
Okay.
So
what's got to be connected to the earth bar for the insulation resistance test? Something I've covered in other videos. Just remind me what's got to be connected.
Yeah, so we've actually left the earthing conductor in. We've left all the bonding conductors in and all the CPCs. We know that we should test our insulation resistance with all of the protective conductors connected together to the main distributor's facility.
So. Yeah, brilliant, yeah. Okay, so this is now line to the protective conductor. If I just come round and have a look. Okay, good reading.
And again, yeah, way above what we need it to be. Again, we're looking at sort of 56, 57 megohms for that.
I'm sure the keen-eyed amongst you have noticed the lead's a bit of a mix and match. Remember, this is the real world. So we're now between the earth bar and neutral. You've left that till last. Any reason behind that one?
Well, it always worries me doing earth and neutral, just because, especially on the old 3036 boards here, it's not going to disconnect any of the actual fuses themselves. So if there's going to be a fault for me, it's generally on this one. So I like the good news of having the high readings first or the acceptable readings first and then the bad news if it comes.
That makes sense, doesn't it? So the customer hasn't said the fuses have been blown at any point. So if it is a neutral and earth fault, it wouldn't blow a fuse, would it?
Yeah, and if you look straight away, we've got a dead short, 0.00 megohms. So I think our next point of call now, because we've tested it as a whole installation, we're going to have to sort of break the circuits down and try and identify which circuit, if it's just one, it could be multiple, have this issue on.
So a little bit of fault finding now. You've got to identify, first of all, the circuit we believe the fault is, if it's one, like you said.
Yeah.
Are we going to do that in what way? How are you going to find the circuit? Because it's not between a line conductor, so there's no point pulling out a breaker. What are you going to have to do?
So I'm going to stay connected and keep all the CPCs in together because, again, we know we should do insulation resistance with them all connected.
Yeah.
So I'm just going to individually take out a neutral conductor one by one, starting probably from the right-hand side.
Okay.
And then I'll test the neutral bar to see if the fault is cleared, and that should give me an idea whether the which circuit it will be.
Okay, so in practice, you're taking out circuit number one, so it's going to be the fourth one, isn't it?
Yeah, always probably.
Is. Whichever order you do.
What I always say, it's always the last one you test, which is the problem.
Okay, yeah. If you test it first, it's not that one. So this will take this neutral out, and you'll go back to neutral bar to earth, and hopefully if this is the fault, we'll see obviously a higher reading on our instrument. So out comes that neutral. I know it's pretty difficult to see. So there we go. So we've disconnected a neutral. Yeah,
been terminated. Great, isn't it?
Okay, so repeat the test now between the earth bar and neutral bar.
Yep.
And our reading is?
Still 0.00 mega ohms.
Ah,
so
okay.
So what I'm going to do quickly, just while I'm here, just to prove it's not multiple circuits, is test to this one, and I've got a value of greater than 909 on this circuit. So I'm sort of eliminating that one from being the problem, because we could find it, put that one back in, and still got a dead short. So basically, we know this one isn't a problem, so we can just carry on with the rest.
So the next circuit is a lighting circuit, and we know when we've been walking around, we've seen a very old outside light, we've seen a joint box on the outside of the building as well.
Yeah.
If you were a betting man, would you suggest it could be this one?
Yeah, but as you've told me numerous times, it's always the last one, the fourth circuit, so...
Circuit number two is the lights.
Yeah.
So disconnecting the neutral, I'm going to repeat the test. We know the circuit that's already out is great, so we don't have to put that one back in. We've insulation resistance tested that on its own. So by removing the lights and going back to the neutral bar, we will be able to prove whether it's that circuit or not. I'm hoping it is. My arms are aching now. So that neutral for the lighting circuit has been disconnected.
Yeah.
And we're going to test between the earth and neutral bars. So we're connected between the earth and neutral bars.
And we have a reading of greater than 100 mega ohms. So definitely more than acceptable. And it is creeping up.
Okay, for those who don't speak screwdriver, that was a little bit more than a... Yeah, that's a great read. So what's that suggesting to you?
So that's suggesting to me that this lighting circuit is the one with the issue. We're just going to confirm that if I just probe onto the end of that. And we have a dead short of 0.0 mega ohms. So yeah, it is the lighting circuit that is causing the issue. So we'll have to do some further investigation on that circuit to sort of see what the issue is, really.
So before we go off looking for this lighting circuit's fault, any other considerations to do with the insulation resistance test when we're thinking about lighting circuits?
Yeah, so naturally there's two-way switching here. So we're going to have to operate both two-way switches and re-perform the insulation resistance test to check the strappers in them switches. So.
Yeah, okay. It's not our problem at the minute because we've got to find the fault.
Yeah. That's the first problem we've got to look at.
I'm sure somebody's going to point it out if we don't mention it. So we'll have a look at these outside lights, but as far as I'm concerned, that's it for this video. We've managed to find an issue. We've managed to do the insulation resistance test from inside of the consumer unit, doing all the circuits at once. And me and Marcus will now nip off and find the fault. But as always, I'm sure we'd like to say the following. What would we like to say?
We hope this video has been some help.